spaces so that we could, that is safe to drive to. Meaning, on the one hand, we detect obstacles. On the other hand, we detect free space. So between those two algorithms, we have redundancy and diversity. We have so much redundancy and diversity all through our system. We do everything two or three different ways and two or three different times so that we can make sure that what we ultimately do is right. Distance perception. Here's using an artificial intelligent network that was trained with LiDAR labeling so that it could predict the distance of objects. Weather. We've trained it with so much data that is now robust across all kinds of poor weather conditions. We use cameras for object detection. We use radars for object detection. We also use LiDARs for object detection. Not just how far away they are, but based on the pattern of dots that are coming back our way, the resolution of LiDAR is not as high as camera, but the depth information is really good. Based on the point cloud that comes back, we do point cloud processing on CUDA, which is incredibly good. We do ICP processing, iterative closest point processing, for registration, and then we use deep learning to detect what those objects are. As I'm watching this, it's just, all of the software and all the technology that has been created to make all of this stuff happen, it's washing over me. And it's truly an amazing.